Hey everyone, it is Tuesday, February 22nd. The time is just after 5 p.m. and the temperature right now is around 3 degrees Celsius. And I guess that would make it 22/2/2022. That's a lot of twos. And I'm here at Bloor Street East. And as you can tell, it's raining. And for this one, I'm going to walk west over to Yonge Street, and then I think I'll walk south down Yonge Street. I'm not quite sure where I'll finish up, probably either at Dundas Square or Queen or King Station. Could normally access Bloor Yonge Station here just on the right. But this entrance has been closed off. That's the entrance there. You could head into the Bloor Yonge residences there. Or the Hudson's Bay department store. And there's a look up at One Bloor East. And it started raining earlier this afternoon. And it's supposed to rain all throughout the evening and into the night. And here we are at Bloor and Yonge. So from an east-west perspective, this is pretty much the center of downtown. That's the very northern end. And we have a scramble crossing. And there's a look at the future Super Tall, One Bloor West. And it's rumored that Apple might be pulling out of the flagship location there. And no, I have still yet to try Chick-fil-A. So I'm walking south down the east side of Yonge Street. And the last time I did a dedicated Yonge Street walking video, I think was around 3 a.m. during a large snowstorm we had last month. There's the LaQuest on Charles Street. There's the CAA theater. Formerly the New Yorker theater. And at last check, this building here was owned by the Church of Scientology. I'm not sure its current status, but it's been boarded up and rather dilapidated for quite a while. You can see a lot of those towers are shrouded in fog. I think that there is a throwback to the old House of Lords barbershop. It used to be right here. I'm a fan of public art, but I can't say I like that one too much. There's the 97 bus that supplements the subway. And I was actually heading out to Pate Village tonight to record a video. But while I was on the subway, I decided, let's just get off at Bloor and Yonge and do a Yonge Street walk instead. And here we are at Yonge and Wellesley. Wellesley Station is just to the east there. think sunset's not till just before 6 p.m. So it should stay lit for the rest of the walk. Developments like this one on the left that are drastically changing the look and feel of Yonge Street. It used to look just like it did across the street here. I remember there's a Korean restaurant in here that was quite good, along with a discount luggage retailer where I bought my current carry-on bag. This is Alexander Street. Like there's a couple of stories planned for this lot. 75 and 78 stories. This is Carlton Street coming up on the left, College on the right. There's a look at College Park. He was honking at that illegally parked car there. Either that or at me. there's a look up at Aura. Although just across the street on the southeast corner of Yonge and Gerrard will soon be a much taller tower. It was originally an 85-story tower that was planned, and it even started construction when the developer went under. And the project was picked up by Concord Annex, the same folks who did City Place. They've unveiled their plans for a 95-story tower. They're currently building an IKEA at the second floor of that building there. You can see some of the living spaces starting to take shape. Here's where that 95-story tower is planned. Right on the former home of the Big Slice. Where that cop is going. There's the iconic Zanzibar. That looks like he's going to the basil box. There's a monster lineup. I think for that tattoo shop maybe.
Have you ever been to Dundas?
And this is Yonge and Dundas. Let's look at the Eaton Centre. Hoping to get a scramble crossing here, but this will do. Okay, it looks like something's been set up at Dundas Square. I'll go take a peek and see what that is. I'm setting this up a few days ago.
There's a way to it.
Bonfire made of light bulb flashes to life, controlled by human warmth. There's where the old Hard Rock Cafe used to be. Now it's, what else? A Shoppers? So I almost slipped. The rain seems to be letting up a bit. Here's Shooter Street. St. Mike's Hospital and Massey Hall are just to the east there. And here's Queen Street coming up. Those cars were right to be honking. There are no right turns at this intersection. Or left turns. There's along Richmond Street. So the financial district is just in on the right here. And here is Adelaide Street. So I think I'm going to finish up just south of here at King Street. Sure, what I'll do if I'll plan another walk or just head home. Good job, Honda driver. $5 Tuesday is a craft. Burgers and beers for $5. I'm gonna have to make a point to go there and try that out. And there goes a King Street car. And here comes another one. A 503 Kingston streetcar, and I think I'm gonna get on it. We'll see where it takes me. Gotta be able to fish out my mask here while I'm doing that. I hope you enjoyed this one, heading south down Yonge Street in the rain on 22/2/22. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below, and if you wish to support the channel, there's links to my Patreon and YouTube channel membership in the description. Gimbal protected, I almost just lost the camera there. So let me know your thoughts and comments down below. And I have an Instagram account at Johnny Strives. Thank you for watching. Thank you.